You have probably clicked on this video because you want to build a video editing PC, which is pretty much good at anything, but your budget is around $1,500. In this video, I'm going to show you the parts if you want to build a killer video editing PC for $1,500. So let's jump right in.
Motion Array is a fantastic tool for creators to make better videos and faster. Motion Array has over 80,000 premium quality templates, presets, plugins, music and sound effects, stock video and photos. In a nutshell, it is a one-stop shop for all your video post-production needs. Configure the membership to suit your needs. Pay annually, monthly, cancel anytime you want, and enjoy your unlimited downloads. Not sure about Motion Array? Go try out the hundreds of free assets available on the website. Check out Motion Array in the video description below.
Just a quick note, I have made reviews pretty much of all of the parts that I'm actually talking about, as well as the CPU, which is the main component in this build. So I highly recommend you check out those reviews on my channel. I'm gonna leave them linked in the description as well as the parts of everything I'm talking about over here. So if you're wondering and you wanna build these things, I'm gonna leave you links down there. You can just click on them and then it will lead you to your local shop worldwide. So whether you're watching from US, Germany, UK, wherever you are from, you can just click on those and they will link you to your local shop so you can buy those parts and get exactly the same parts and know that the compatibility of all of those will work. If you want to know how this PC will be built, then I'm going to be building very similar system with using a lot of those same components very soon on the channel. So hit subscribe if you want to see that, or you can just check out some of the previous builds I've done on the channel and you can just, you know, switch out your component and then you'll know how to build this PC. Let's jump right in. First of all, the CPU, which is the core of this build. This is also the best bang for buck build, I think. If you're gonna go any less than that, you're gonna seriously hinder the performance. And if you're gonna go any higher than that, you're gonna pay a lot more than that. So I do think this is the best bang for buck of the whole build. And the CPU I have chosen is the i5-12600K. And if you haven't seen the review of this chip yet, then you really need to go check it out because the tables have turned and the best bang for buck in the lower end or this, it has gone back to Intel. It's not AMD anymore. And this chip is so impressive that it even managed to keep up overall score with the Ryzen 9 5950X 16 core monster, which is ridiculous. And a lot of the performance of this CPU comes from the iGPU that's inside the chip as well. So you've got a little GPU inside the CPU, which also helps with video encoding and decoding, especially when you're working with H.264 and 5 codecs. If you are a DaVinci Resolve editor, then the news is even better for you because every single H.265 codec is hardware accelerated with this GPU. So even if you're running like 10-bit 422 or 444 codec of H.265, whatever frame rates, this is absolutely gonna breeze through it like you're editing 720p footage on a high-end desktop PC. Go check out the timeline performance of this CPU, on my channel and you'll see what I'm talking about. For Premiere Pro users, the news aren't so good, but still a lot of the main H.264 and 5 codecs are accelerated on the iGPU, which makes this chip just like there is nothing like that on the market. And it performs even better than the 5900X, 5950X from the Ryzen systems. And that's why we're going with this Intel system. Next of all, we need to put this CPU into a motherboard. And for you, I have two options and I'll explain why. I have two boards. One of them is the Gigabyte Z690 Aero G DDR4. And the other option is Asus ProArt B660 Creator D4 motherboard. Now, both of these motherboards are DDR4, which I think you should be going for that budget. DDR5 is not worth it in your budget. Just don't go for it. If you want to know how much DDR5 is better or worse, go check it out on my channel. I've got it linked up there as well. Both of these motherboards cost roughly around the same amount, roughly around $290 or so. But the very good thing about this Asus ProArt board is that if you are using Adobe Premiere Pro or in fact any of the Adobe apps and you've got Creative Cloud membership, then with this board, you're gonna get 3 months for free. even if you already have the license, you can still redeem them and not pay for 3 months or get 3 months extra, which you can deduct from the cost of this motherboard. And the 3 months, depending on your situation, if you're a business, then it can be up to $238. Obviously, if you're individual, it's roughly around $150, $160 or something like that, which makes this board very, very affordable. It doesn't have quite as many features as this Gigabyte Aero G over here. So if you are DaVinci Resolve editor, for example, and you don't have Creative Cloud membership, then this Aero G might be a better option for you because this has a lot more options. There's 4 M.2 storage over here. They're all PCIe 4.0 capability. A lot of fast USB ports, USB-C ports. You've got Wi-Fi and Bluetooth built in. Everything you pretty much want is on this motherboard, and it's amazing. Even video output through USB-C, which is very unique. This is the best DDR4 motherboard for the 12th Gen 4 creators. Go check out the review if you want to know more about this board, or if you want to know more about this board, the review for this is out there as well. It is great, the motherboard. It's very affordable if you count in the price difference of Creative Cloud, but at the same time, if you have to pay full fat price for both of them, then I think you should go with this board because this board is better. Now we have the motherboard and CPU. There is time to cool this system down. And for the cooler, I have chosen this guy over here. This is the Arctic Freezer 34 Esports Duo. And I was super impressed with this cooler when we tested this cooler on the 12900K that pulled 240 watts from the socket. And it was actually able to keep up with that. Now the 12600K has much less of a TDP and there isn't that much to worry about. So this cooler is gonna keep up with it very, very well. And it's very affordable. You can get this for roughly around $46, and depending on the color schemes, because there's different colors available for this cooler, you pick the one you want depending on, you know, which motherboard you go for and which case color. So there's options for you there. Some of the colors are a little bit more expensive or less expensive, but this black gray version is $46 and it's amazing cooler for that price point. Links in the description below. Next off, the RAM. And for RAM, I have chosen the Teen Group TFOS Vulcan Z and 32 gigabytes of it. 32 gigabytes, I think, is the minimum spot you should be going for when doing video editing or 4K video editing. And you know, you're a wedding filmmaker, you're doing freelancing or something like that. It's okay amount, but if you can, one of the first things I would upgrade is the RAM to 64 gigabytes, which is just double the amount of DDR4, which is just double the cost of 32 gigabytes. So 32 gigabytes of this RAM will cost you roughly around $109, and 64 gigabytes is gonna cost you $220. I'm gonna leave the links for both of these in the description below. But this RAM is just the best bang for buck in the middle ground there. You're gonna get the most for your money, the most performance. I have tested faster RAM kits and DDR5 and even DDR5, and this RAM is not far behind, and you're only gonna lose a few percent, but the price is gonna ramp up very, very quickly. That's why we're going with this particular model and spec of RAM. A tip over here is I highly recommend you go with dual stick rather than 4 sticks of the capacity you want. So in the future, you can actually double the capacity if you need more RAM. For example, if you wanna start with 32 gigabytes, just plug it in there. And then later on, when you want to upgrade, you can upgrade it to 64 gigabytes. Next off, we need to have an SSD to run our programs and projects. Now, this is the part that's often overspent on. It really depends on your workflow and your budget, you know, how much you need of this. I have chosen 1 terabyte of a drive, and this is in this enclosure over here. I'm using these for my external SSDs. But inside here is the Western Digital SN550. And it's about 2.4 gigabytes per second read and write speeds. And you're paying about $80 or $90 for it, roughly around there, which is a seriously good price for it. And even if you want the SATA, you know, the old school 2.5 inch SSDs, old school, this is really going to be cheaper for that, because some of these SATA SSDs for 1 terabyte are going to be around $100, and this is 4 to 5 times faster than the SATA drives and costs less. Now there is few deals and few options available. Even when I'm making this video, I found the Sabrent Rocket 1TB, the PCIe 3.0 drive for $85, which is even faster and even better drive. And I've been using these on a lot of my builds. So I highly recommend this drive. On another drive I'm gonna leave in the description as well is the Crucial P2, which is roughly around the same speed as this Western Digital SN550. So all of these drives are very good for your operating system, and depending on your needs, you might already have some drives, but I recommend you get another drive for your project drive, where you put all your video project files in there and then you edit off that, so your programs and projects are separately. If you want to know how, you know, the real storage workflow should work, then I've got another separate video on the channel. Feel free to check that out up there. I'm not sure if I have enough cards to put up there. I'm gonna leave it in the description below if it's not up there. And then another video I highly recommend you is the SSD mistakes that creators can make when buying the SSD mistakes, or some of the brandings and lots of things that people often not think about. I've got a full guide how to choose a create SSD for your workflow, even if you're on a budget or a high-end creator. Feel free to check that out. I'm gonna leave it in the description as well. Now the GPU. The stuff that is probably the most interesting about the part and yet the hardest to find on the world at the moment. For this build, I have chosen the RTX 3060, and you can get that roughly around $800 new on Amazon or eBay or different retailers, depending if you can get it for MSRP or any of the queues or Newegg Shuffle, for example. You're gonna get it even cheaper, but it's very like normal price to pay $800 for it, you know, in the market at the moment. Hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it's gonna be even cheaper. But the reason we're choosing RTX 3060 and nothing above it, because you have a killer media engine inside the CPU. Well, you have a GPU inside your CPU, which makes the video playback already so much faster, and you don't really need the NVIDIA encoders inside the GPU. So the RTX 3060 is well enough for any of the 4K editing you're doing, even complex, you know, wedding projects that are layers and layers of different stuff. It's gonna be well enough for that. So if you're wondering which RTX 3060 you should buy for, just go for whichever one is the cheapest. Even the LHR low hash rate, they're pretty much performing exactly the same as the 3060 in creative video editing performances. So you don't need to worry about that. Just go with any of the RTX 3060s you can find. I'm gonna leave a few links in the description below. Two more things we need for this build is the power supply and case. For the power supplies, the prices vary different things. What I really recommend you to go for is something solid. Don't really cheap out on the power supply, because it's not that big of a difference in terms of price, but the quality can be massively different. So higher quality power supplies will give you 10 or 12 years of warranty on the power supply, so you have a peace of mind that, you know, the juice that you're giving to all of your components is very high quality. It's not, you know, it's like buying a race car and putting cheap fuel in. You really want to put the high quality fuel in to make the highest performance and to get the best engine performance and all that. So for that, I have chosen the EVGA Supernova 650 watt power supply, because at the moment I found this on a deal for $70, which is amazing. It's a fully modular power supply, 650 watts, which is plenty to power all of our systems over here. And we have even a little higher headroom, and it's very power efficient as well. It's 80 plus gold power rated. I'm also gonna leave a few other options in the description below, just in case the EVGA, you know, spikes in price, or you want a different model, you wanna go with maybe some Corsair ones or Be Quiet ones or Seasonic ones or something like that. I'm gonna leave a few options in the description below. Now, last of all, the case of this build. I've got this case over there actually, and you'll see some B-roll hopefully of this, because it's too big. I don't have space to put another PC here on the table, but the case is Corsair 4000D, and we're not gonna go with the Airflow version. There is an Airflow version as well. If you wanna check this out, I'm gonna leave it in the description as well, but it's slightly more expensive. But the truth is, the non-airflow version is pretty good at airflow as well. So depending like which look you like, and if you want the more airflow, which isn't that, you know, big of a difference It's plenty of airflow even with the non-airflow version. And this case is gonna cost you around $75. And there's a black and white versions available, so you can choose which one you want. You know, depending on the theme you will go for here, or the cooler, or the GPU, you can customize this. And that's the good bit of building your own PC for, you know, video editing. And that's gonna wrap up the build. And this is very high quality parts. All of them are very high quality parts, and you can have the peace of mind that these will last and you're not getting anything cheap or anything, you know, random. That brings me to the point of why you shouldn't still buy a pre-built PC but build your own. I understand that, you know, building a PC might be a little bit scary for a lot of people, but if you look at some of the tutorials, just have a look at my like 1 hour long build video, how to build a PC, and you'll see it's not actually that hard. And just reading the manual, it might take a little bit of time, your whole day, spend one day building a PC, but you'll get something very, very good. Because if you compare a price of this to something pre-built, just have a look online, any pre-built for the same price, like around $1,500-$1,600, you're gonna get either pants, which in UK means just rubbish, pants components, very low quality power supply, like maybe the CPU and GPU is the only like quality stuff, everything else is cheap, your motherboard is something cheapest that you can find, and it's very low end, and it's not worth it. And that's why I think you're still gonna get a better deal when building your own. And it's the same with going with Apple. A lot of people, you know, you might be wondering, or you wanna debate in the comments below, or you should be getting a MacBook Pro for the same amount. Honestly, for this price point, this will absolutely wipe the MacBook Pros. Because if you want the MacBook Pro with the M1 Pro chip, you're gonna pay a little bit more than our budget over here, and you're stuck with your choice. Here, you have so much more upgradability, and you can use some of the components later on. You can, if you want to, you can get an i7 or i9, put it in there, you get even faster performance, but you don't have to. You can really like configure it to your budget, whereas when you go in with Apple, you don't have to. And if you're wondering how the performance will work, I've got a video on my channel, you can do some research in there, but Apple is, you know, it's very good in terms of portability, but I think you're still gonna get best performance for your money, best bang for buck, if you're building this system compared to the Apple system. So everything I've talked about is linked in the description below if you want to pick out any of those parts and build it. Thanks guys for watching. As always, subs if you'd like to see more, likes if you enjoyed this video, and I'll meet you in the comments section below. Good luck with building this PC, and let me know if you have built this. And if you want to see me build something very similar, we'll do that soon. Bye bye.